Hello everybody, my name is whimreaper and welcome to another speed build. So it's been a long time since I've done one of these. I'm a little bit rusty on the commentary, but nevertheless, I'm confident that today's video is going to be a lot of fun. I had a lot of fun making this house, and it actually got quite a good reception on the gallery already, so that's a change from when I normally do speed builds. It seems like they never get attention on the gallery until after I post a video, but this one already is doing quite well. And with this one, as you can tell, it is for my 100 baby challenge. So we're hopefully going to be moving into this bad boy sometime soon. I really do want to get out of that other one. I don't know why, it just feels so blah to me. It's probably just because I have to look at it so much. You guys have had to look at it so much. And we're just ready to move on to this little beach house I've made in Windenburg. So I went with this beachy kind of theme, partially because I'm really like going stir crazy and I just want it to be summer already. And in Canada, it's like snowing every second day still. So yeah, that's kind of insane. And I'm just ready to be able to at least sit in the yard, even if I can't go out and stuff. I just want to sit in the yard. I want to like plant some seeds, you know? So that's what kind of got me into making this house, is just wanting the weather to be better. So I was like, you know what? Windenburg is a beautiful place to build this little beach house. So you can see, I got this kind of strange shape, and I really do struggle to roof this for a while. I think I cut out most of the roofing because of that. It just kind of, it was awkward, you know? So I kind of took it out, I think. But yeah, I'm just like really happy that we're gonna be moving into a new landscape. I'm just getting so bored of Brindleton Bay, and like Brindleton Bay is a lovely world and all, but then also there's pets everywhere, and it always made me so sad that we can't really have a pet in this challenge. Like technically you can, but it's gonna hold you back by a lot if you have a pet. So I've decided we're not gonna do that for us personally in this challenge, at least not until maybe like the very end of the challenge. So that's why we're just gonna be moving, refreshing it up a little bit. And these columns I've got going, I really love the idea of them, but I was like struggling to make them look nice and sensible until I get to the back of the house, and then I figured out a little trick. Just because I put columns where there wasn't a roof directly to support it, so I had to actually double layer some columns. Also, I think I did totally forget about the trick where you can just stretch the columns to be whatever height you want, but you know what, that actually made everything easier for me, so it is perfectly fine by me. So yeah, I wanted to put a greenhouse type area on this house. That was my main thing that I wanted to do, was get on this kind of like little garage type section, which is what the bricked off section currently is going to end up being. And I don't know why, I just saw a lot of builds on Pinterest that had that kind of vibe to it, and I was like really excited to do something similar. And it's like kind of sort of industrial, but like it's more like modern beachy, I don't know. And like, I do call this a modern beach house, I think, on the gallery. Realizing it's not all that modern, but it's still got a lot of modern influences and modern decorating, so I think it's pretty excusable. Now, that little, what is it called? The dormer that you see up on the third floor is actually accessible, and I was so happy I could do this, because I just find that when you, in the 100 baby challenge, when you're playing, your Sims are always like out in the open, and then you can just see them like sleeping in the background in the bedroom sometimes, and they don't really do much else in the bedroom. Sometimes they sit on the bed to do homework, but that's not that exciting either. So I made that into the teen's bedroom. So that means that when they're in there, we are not gonna worry about them. They're just having the sleep, they're doing homework, whatever. I didn't put any entertainment in there. So I thought that was a good way to kind of use that area of the house without having to worry about it being difficult to look at during videos. And as you can see, I kind of changed up the look of that greenhouse section there. And the greenhouse is kind of a greenhouse, like I do put in flowers and whatever, but also it is just an activity room, because it's like quite a large space actually, and I kind of ran out of things, to be honest with you, put in there, so that's actually a really good thing, meaning we'll have a lot of skills to work on in this challenge. So for the layout of this house, I kind of just went with my gut, you know? Like, I don't think I referenced anything for this house layout. It was just completely random. And a lot of the time, that's when I do my best work, but it's also some of my longest work, if you know what I mean. Like, it takes me a long time to be happy and satisfied with what I do. So that's why this video is a bit longer. You can obviously skip throughout to get the vibe of the whole house. And we don't really do a tour at the end, but I thought it wasn't really necessary since you can see everything going on in this video quite clearly. And you'll also get to see it in a lot of other videos if you watch my 100 Baby Challenge episodes. So this basement area I thought would be a good area for the kids' room. And now that's because you always want to have the toddler room on the most accessible floor. And that floor, I think, is actually the top, the second story, because of the way this house is set up. Otherwise, the toddlers would have to constantly be taken outside from in the greenhouse, and I don't know if I like that. We'll see how it plays out during the actual challenge, but I thought that the kids' room would work best downstairs because they can get to it easily, they can go upstairs from it easily to get to the kitchen where they need to get food, whereas toddlers, if they need to get to the kitchen, they take hours to go up and downstairs, and they might starve if you don't actually just like put them on the same floor. So that's my reasoning behind that. We'll see how it works out. We could add in a mini kitchen downstairs too, which would also solve the problem, and then we could have the toddlers down there. But I just didn't feel like there was enough room upstairs for a kid's room that would also have enough room for like three of beds, you know? Because sometimes you do have three kids at a time. Sometimes you have more than that. Sometimes you have like four. Obviously, they can also occupy the teen room at that point, but I wasn't really getting worried about that quite yet. We don't know what's going to come in the challenge. And yeah, I really struggled with wallpapers in this house a lot. So I think I skipped most of me doing the wallpapers, hopefully, because it's a little bit painful. And then just move on to furnishing the bedroom, basically. I did put in like windows over here, and I don't really know how I feel about those ones from university, but they worked well on this wall anyway. I don't remember exactly what I ended up using. Oh yeah, I ended up using those slatted ones. That's kind of a more old-fashioned look, I think, so to say that this is modern isn't entirely accurate, but I still like the look. It definitely reminds me of the condos that I used to stay in when I was a kid in Fernie, BC. So if you've ever been there, that might kind of remind you of those. I don't know, the actual layout of the house doesn't though, but the interior definitely does. I always kind of take accidental Canadian influences into all my builds. So yeah, that's what's going on in this one. I'm just lighting everything up here as usual. Those ones are just great for getting a lot of light really easily. And I put in a closet in the basement because I didn't think I would fit in enough wardrobes, but I totally did. But at least the kids can actually use that closet to like play inside of, which would be kind of fun. Also, I think there's closet room too, so that might be interesting to introduce. We haven't done that before, but yeah. So that's what I just ruined that little corner there. I was thinking about making the bathroom downstairs larger, but I really don't think that's necessary. We don't want our sins spending too much time there. And then, yeah, I think moving on to, yeah, we're just doing floor tiling. And I really love that tile from Dino. I recently just got Dino, and I was just shocked at how many beautiful items came in it, and I was just, like, kind of disappointed myself for not getting it sooner. But this outside area, yeah, we carry out the tile out here. And then we kind of end up with an outdoor playroom too, which is kind of fun. Well, it's not a room, but like, it's kind of fun because then we're going to be seeing a lot more of the outside of the house if we use this area. We're going to not be stuck indoors so much in this challenge, which I am really, really fond of. I really didn't want to be in the dinginess all the time, and I thought that having a two-story house might actually help with that, although it'll be a little bit more difficult for me to film. But I think that it'll balance out. So here we are making The matriarch's room. I'm actually very unsure whether Rita will ever live in this house, you guys, which is kind of a scary thought. Which is, like, I was making this whole house with her in mind. I'm like, what would Rita pick for the wallpaper? What would she want for her bedroom? Like, what kind of, yeah, like, how would she decorate the kids' room? Would she have a separate bathroom for the father? Of course she would, that's just who she is. But, like, we don't know who's gonna end up being the main matriarch in this house, because Rita is almost an elder, and we're not, I don't think we're close to affording this yet. I think we might need, like, 10,000 to 20,000 more simoleons, which is a lot of money to be investing. But as you see, I kind of, like, went with a nice little, I don't know how to explain it. It's kind of, like, homey, kind of, like, a little bit modern, but also, like, really just, like, soft, and I don't know. I just feel like it's, very beachy without being overly beachy. Like, it's kind of still got that modern touch. It's very simple. I don't know what it is with me and simple interiors, but I've just been doing them like crazy, and I can't seem to get away from it. I can't force myself to put in a ton of clutter anymore, and just, like, part of it is because I want my house to be affordable, and they used to end up being like 200,000 simoleons for a regular house, and that's just a little overboard. And then a part of it is also just, I can't, like, playing in those cluttered houses is, like, it's kind of nice, but everything gets in the way of your sight lines. So that's something I really kept in mind when I was making this build, is that if I put a bunch of things on the walls, you're gonna see them come up in other rooms, because I usually play with the walls, like, half up. And I didn't want to be totally distracted from what my Sims were doing in this house, constantly trying to peer around with decorations and stuff. Rita's room, that being said, is going to be a little bit difficult to see into, but I think that's excusable, simply because the only time we're going to be using her room is taking care of babies and for Lulu, possibly. So I think that's okay. But anyhow, I got that kind of modern style going, and I carried it on into the kitchen. I skipped most of the kitchen because I was struggling so much. I wanted to put in that little, what is it called? It's like a skylight, but I used it on the floor. I don't know. That little just, like, see-through section there, I wanted to use that really badly, but I couldn't find a way to make the island counters fit it until, like, I think it took me 10 minutes in speed build time. So, like, I don't even know how long that is in real life, way too long. So I cut that all out and put in this little sink over here. So yeah, it's all nice and accessible. I feel like this is going to be a really good layout for the kids to, like, hang out and do their homework and just have access to the kitchen really easily, because I found in our other kitchen it was hard to navigate around it a little bit, and I changed that up, and it's not too bad now, but before it was really bad because of how many island counters were had. So I made sure just to put the sink over there, and I thought that would make it a lot less cluttered. Maybe they'll cook over there too, who knows, but I was kind of hoping they would stick, like, keep the cooking to the one wall and keep the microwaving or whatever else to this one. I don't think I actually do end up with a microwave though. We do have a dishwasher, which is good. I think we still have one in my current house, but I don't think they ever use it, which is kind of weird. So I can just, like, remember to actually use that. It would be great. I'm putting in this nice little, oh, this is not little, this giant table. And it's gonna be, like, much more of a noticeable, like, dining area. Usually, I've been, like, just pushing the dining area away and just kind of justifying it by, like, we need the space. But in this house, I don't think we need the space. We have, like, enough space for almost everything we could possibly need. The bedrooms could be a bit bigger, but, like, they don't spend enough time in there just for me to really think that's important. So as you can see, I just popped in that light from Dine Out, and I got this really peachy kind of thing going on in the main rooms, which I really adore that. I don't know if I keep the tile in the kitchen or not, by the way. It really does look good looking at it right now, but I think I might have changed it up. I think I want it to be more modern, but we'll see. And then I put in those shelves like that. I think that looks adorable, and it's just like a simple decoration without being too much, and I just chucked in some clutter items. Now, because of all these clutter items and decorations, I have a feeling this house is going to be a little bit more expensive for us than I first thought it would be. I just wanted it to feel more alive than it currently felt, or just without any decorations I put in them. I don't know what I put on the table. I always put something on the table. But I did put this cute little picnic nook outside. I just love it. I think that it'll be so cute if we could get, like, the kids to come outside and eat on the lawn and maybe have a weenie roast when we can afford a campfire. I didn't put in a few things that I did want simply just because I didn't want to run out of money. I wanted to be able to afford this house fairly decently early on, you know? Especially since I'm thinking about doing like the rags to riches with a new matriarch, then I don't want to have to work up to like 100,000 simoleon house if Rita doesn't end up being able to afford this one. So yeah, that's gonna be interesting to see how quickly we can earn our money for this house. But I have been working on it, you guys. I think you guys can see that based on my other episodes where all my off-camera time is just Rita like writing and writing and writing. And she's getting so many royalties now because she's such a good writer. So I think we're gonna be able to afford it before she becomes an elder, but maybe not very much. Like, I think the new matriarch will probably be like in the household by the time that she buys this, which is kind of scary to think about. And I'm not really ready to let go of Rita yet, you guys, but it might happen. So yeah, you can see I'm putting in this little garden. I thought it looked super beachy, super cute, and just like had a little pop of color behind the fence there. And I just kind of wanted this whole house to be like really light feeling. I felt like our other house was kind of getting dragged down by the lack of windows. And this house doesn't have all that many more windows, you guys. Like, I'm not gonna lie to you, it's not like super duper bright. But I think that the light colors and just like the whole beach aesthetic of the house really helps to make it just like a lot more cohesive and a lot more open and just nicer seeming. I think the basement needs a lot of work, actually. Like, I'm finished with it and I'm happy with it for now, but it still feels quite dingy to me. And that being said, it's not actually a basement, it's a walkout level. So it should have a lot more light. It's just, I didn't want to put in a whole wall of windows, make it look super tacky just for the light source. I think we're gonna have to figure out other ways to make it look a little bit brighter down there, maybe change up the color scheme. I'm not sure yet, but I just wanted the downstairs to be kind of like an area for skill building and for the kids to hang out, and it would be the easiest level to record on for sure. So I'm thinking that the Sims are gonna spend a lot of time down there, so I might as well make it quite nice to look at, you know, but I don't think it did badly, I'll say that much, but when you go to download it, I don't think it'll be like the same as what we finally end up choosing. And I did put in a little television this time. I kind of juggled the idea of not having one, and I just thought like, no, we should go for it. Like, they don't really actually end up using it that much anymore. I found in like past, past versions of the game, I think maybe they were more inclined to use the television like all the time, whereas in this playthrough, I think the triplets used it the most, and they really weren't on it all that much, so I think we'll be okay. And then it's at least like a fast way to get fun up. You can get some aspiration points by doing that. And then I put in that little scroll in the bathroom, which is from Island Living, which obviously this is not an island beach house, it's just a lake ocean beach house. I don't know how to explain, but yeah, I do realize that the roof is sticking through, but I just decided that instead of playing around with the floor plan a whole bunch and getting rid of a whole bunch of usable space, I'll just pop a bed right over top of it and it'll work fine. I did put a desk in here, but then changed my mind about it being there because we already have a desk in that wall nook that you saw me make, which has all the windows on it, which I thought was really exciting. I don't want to put a computer there simply. I think we're going to take the computer from our current house, and then that will go there, or I either did that or there's one in the basement. It's been a long time since I made this to you guys. I really struggled editing this one because of how long it was, and it's still very, very long, and I didn't really take that much out. But I wanted to show, like, the full experience of this house because I am quite proud of it. I did take a long time building it, and that's why it's not as speedy as a lot of speed builds you'll see. But then you can also really get the feel for what I'm doing in it. And I love this toddler room. It's just really simple and cute and just like kind of bright feeling. And I did take the wall down, realized that hot air movement is kind of annoying, but it's in the bathroom area, so I don't think it'll be too distracting. Now, this is the toddler bathroom I was talking about earlier. And the reason that I'm having a separate bathroom for the toddlers is then I can lock it for certain sims. So that means that our kids and our teens aren't going to be taking baths anymore, which is just so, so good. Like, Rita might, or the matriarch, whoever it is, might still, like, take a bath once in a while because it'll have to be open to the matriarch. But that way, they're not going to be constantly, like, going in the bath when they just need to take a quick shower. And then, anyway, this is the upstairs space I was talking about. That's going to be the teens room. So I only put in, like, a couple things. I put in a bookshelf so they can read up here, or I can go grab a book from here and then read downstairs. But I don't think we need to watch them reading, you know? Like, it's just there as a decoration, kind of, because I didn't want this space to feel lifeless. There is a little closet there you can see from the mosquito stuff pack. I thought that looked adorable in this room. But otherwise, I think there might be a mirror, and that's about it, as far as skill building stuff goes. And I think I did put in a guitar, but then I end up moving it later. I'm not exactly positive about that. I didn't want to rewatch this whole thing and then record the voiceover, because it's already taken me so long to get this out. I hope you guys understand. But I do remember my thought process while building, I just don't remember exactly how it turned out. So this is the kids' room I was talking about. I end up going with jungle adventure beds, which is a lot better than what they currently have, but they're not amazing quality, you know? But I thought that they were cute and they fit the beach theme well enough that they can go in here. Also, I remembered to buy that teddy bear doctor set because that is so good for kids to get up their empathy skill, or character value, that is. And that would be so helpful so that when they become teens, they can just only volunteer a couple times instead of volunteering like 4 times, and then just age up really fast that way. And that being said, I really don't like aging up kids in this challenge fast anymore, which is the point, because you want your matriarch to constantly be pregnant so she doesn't die as quickly as she would have otherwise. So it's kind of like this weird juggle I have where it's like I want to age up the kids, but I also really don't, because like I want new kids to be in the household, but I don't want to see the ones that we've invested all our time in and like made personalities for and relationships with. I don't want to see them go, but at least you can go visit them in later episodes. And then, yeah, we're moving on to this greenhouse. I did put a flower arranging station in, so that could end up being a skill that we invest more in the future. And I put in some workout equipment since I thought that was quite fitting for this little area to just be a nice, like, semi-outdoor, semi-indoor room. I did put the chess table outdoors. We don't use it all that much in this challenge anyway, but I thought it looked really nice there. And I put a yoga mat outside. I was gonna try to blend it into that rug so then they could just do yoga on like the little picnic blanket, but instead I just stick it out there, or I might move it inside. I don't quite remember what I ended up doing with that one, but yeah. This whole basement level, like as you can see, I went with a gray down here, and I think I should go with a white maybe. It's a very, very small change to make, however. I just like to put a lot of variability in my houses. I didn't want to go with all white everywhere, but I think the gray makes it look a little dingy for my face, especially since the afternoon sun doesn't seem to shine through those back windows. We're going to want to change that up just a little bit. So yeah, I did end up moving that inside, but it is just a nice little workout, yoga, botanical garden type area. And then, yeah, you can see that music corner went in there. I don't know if I have a guitar or not. I thought I did. I don't know why I wouldn't have added it. I guess just so it wasn't as expensive to make his house, but... Oh well. Yeah, so I think we put in a desk here. I don't know if I put a computer on this desk, like I said. And then I put in this, like, beautiful built-in bookshelf kind of vibe. But it ends up being a lot darker in tone than I intended, and I think that's just because I try to match it to the windows on the right side of the screen that are all, like, what is it? The slide windows. And then it ends up being kind of dingy and blending into the wall. I think I could just improve on the color scheme without changing any of the objects, and this room would just be so much nicer. But I'm, like, really happy with how the layout is, and just, like, the overall vibe of it. And I think I did end up putting in a better computer than what we normally have. No, it's the same one. So I might actually just delete that one and then bring over our old one. But we'll just see. Like, I don't think it's going to cause that big of a difference if we just buy a new one. But yeah, this room was kind of hard to decorate. I wanted to put in this rug here just to fill up more space and make it look more full when it really isn't all that full. But, yeah, I didn't really know how to decorate it very well, especially because a lot of the skill building items that I would have put in here, I put outside or in the greenhouse room otherwise. Like, I was like, oh, I could put in a workout area in the basement, but I really didn't need it. So, yeah, I don't know. That area is quite empty, but then at least we can expand on that later. Putting some little equipment for the kids to play on, get up their motor skill, and then I actually put in a full-size outdoor dining table, which I don't know why, that's kind of bougie, you know? Like, not that many people have that, but I think it looks so cute, and it was just like a nice place to hang out beside the garden, and I thought it looked really, really good. So with that, I really hope that you enjoyed this speed build, and I hope to see you in another episode, and yeah, download link in the description as always. Goodbye!